Okay, this is a video real quick that'll show you how to set your overlap, which will allow you to make adjustments on your intake and exhaust valves as well as your injector height. Okay, now between the DDEC 4 and the DDEC 5, there's different ways of setting the injectors. I'm not going to go into that till the next video, but this is how this goes. On your intake manifold, excuse me, your intake valve, you will rotate the camshaft to directly under the roller bearing on your intake valve assembly. Okay, so your camshaft is going to be more likely about 5 to 10 degrees towards the passenger side of the truck if you're looking at it. But to make the adjustment, you get on the driver's side, have somebody bar the motor over and just kind of watch the lobe as it comes directly underneath the roller bearing on your intake valve assembly.
What we have here is cylinder number 2. This intake valve is all the way up.
Okay, now what will happen is your valve follower, or your spring, whatever you want to call it, is going to be at maximum depression when this lobe is at maximum elevation. Simple enough. What goes up must come down. Now, if you want to get real crazy with it, or if you want to just double check your work, and until you get good at this, I'd suggest you do it. Put a dial indicator up on this arm. Once you get it, this lobe at maximum elevation, the valve spring, maximum compression, put a dial indicator up here and move the camshaft back and forth until you get the exact reading or the maximum depression on it. Okay, you'll get a feel for it once you do it a few times, but it's important that it be at maximum depression. Now you have 3 or 4 degrees either side to play with, but when you stop and think about it, that's only about 1/8 of an inch total that you can be off, and that's not left and right. That's 1/8 inch between the left and the right, or 1/16 of an inch. So you got to be pretty much spot on with this stuff. That's how you set your intake valve overlap. Okay,
so this is the cylinder that's ready to adjust. The paired cylinder has been set at the correct valve lash adjustment. Here you can see the roller bearing for the intake and exhaust valve assemblies, and you notice how freely they spin. And then this center lobe is for the injector, and that's the one you would torque down to 40 inch pounds and back it off 3/4 of an inch, but this cylinder is ready to adjust.
Okay, so when we're talking about doing a valve job, valve adjustment, valve lash adjustment, whatever you want to call it, this is how this works. When you set the cylinder number 1 valve overlap, as we just discussed, then you would do the injector height. And on a DDEC 5, you would also do the injector height and the valves on cylinder number 6. And then it would rotate. So cylinder number 5, once you set the valve overlap, intake valve overlap, then you would do the injector and intake and exhaust valves on cylinder number 2. And then 3 and 4, 6 and 1, 2 and 5, 4 and 3, and so on. And here's why. When you're cylinders are stacked up inside the motor, 3 and 4 will be at top dead center, 1 and 6 will be at bottom dead center, 2 and 5 in transit. And conversely, when 1 and 6 are at top dead center, 3 and 4 are down, 2 and 5 are in transit. So you have pairs of cylinders that run basically like steps. We're going to show you a picture of that here in a minute.
Okay, so this is what I mean by the pairing of the cylinders and also how they're stacked up. You can see from the right to the left that cylinder 1, 2, and 3 coming from the front of the engine heading towards the back on the firewall. So cylinder 3 is on its way to top dead center. Then you have cylinder 2 and cylinder 1, 1 being the lowest. And this is true with all motors. Here you can see how the cylinders are stacked, moving from the front to the rear. 1, 2, there's 3 and 4 at bottom dead center, 4, 5, and 6. There's 6 at top dead center, moving towards top dead center. This is on a CAT C15, but you can clearly see the pairing and the stepping in this video.
So when cylinder number one, you do your injector, you do your intake valve overlap, and you make your adjustments on cylinder six and vice versa. But you don't have to bar the motor over 360 or 720 degrees to get there. You just basically bar it over 120 degrees at a time and make the adjustments.